is nothing better than spending time with such a noble beast, a horse, a horse, my kingdom for a horse, said Shakespeare's Richard III. Undoubtedly, many of us would like to mount a horse and gallop through an open field. It looks really simple to onlookers, but in truth, riding a horse is a science and art in and of itself, which the guests of the Generation UA program will tell us about today. This is Avalon. He's my best friend. Can't spend a day without him. Equestrianism is a part of my life. When I'm on a horse, I'm in full harmony with it. After the collapse of the Soviet Union, we had hard times. Of course, everything fell into neglect, and little by little we started to revive the craft. We bought horses and rebuilt the infrastructure, and through these years we have managed, as you can see, to acquire a new riding hole, rebuild the previous one and repair the stables. We have achieved a new level that we aimed for. Equestrianism in Ukraine is gradually becoming more and more popular. Only 10 years ago, it was not so popular. Our athletes travel abroad to take part in international competitions, but the sport is a lot more popular abroad than it is here, because their level is higher and the horses are better. The first time I rode a horse was in early childhood. I started training on weekends when I was around 8 years old. Then, when I was 11, my father brought me to a stable, and since then, I've been spending every day of my life in that stable for 10 years now. Cleaning and grooming a horse is a tricky process and not everyone likes it. Some horses like being cleaned. They can enjoy it for hours without it irritating them. They simply like the attention. Then there are horses which are very sensitive and don't like being cleaned. So we try to get through this painstaking process as quickly as possible.
Подтолкнули меня к конному спорту родители, и узнала я вообще о таком виде спорта, как конный спорт, в лет 12 только.
Изначально my parents got me into equestrianism. That's how I discovered this sport at age of 12. At first, they got me into a sport to strengthen my back, to give me something to stay busy with after school. My father was also into equestrianism in his youth, so you can say that I've basically followed his footsteps. I currently work with two horses, Avalon and Crystal. Avalon is 9 years old, Crystal is 5. We've been working with Avalon for 4 years. We've been through a lot with him. First races, first competitions. First for him, not for me, but it was kind of first for me because the horse was young and unpredictable. It was very interesting. I've been working with Crystal for 2 years. He is a young stallion. The most I like about this sport is the thrill, the excitement of competition, the agonistic spirit. It allows me to show myself. Of course, I want to excel in every training session to succeed, and of course, spending time with my friends is also very important to me.
Проявить себя тоже, максимально выкладываться на каждой тренировке, чтобы добиться успеха. Ну, конечно, общение с друзьями – это тоже это очень важно для меня.
У моего дедушки есть конюшня, я приехал ему в гости.
My grandfather has a stable, and I asked him once to let me try riding a horse. The first time I mounted a horse was when I was 9 years old, and I liked it from the start. Thanks to my granddad, I began engaging in equestrian sports. He has helped me a lot, for which I am very grateful for him. In 4 years, I moved to Kyiv and continued here. I was really into this sport because it's so cool communicating with a horse. It's very cool and sentimental. There are three classic equestrian sport types: eventing, show jumping, and dressage. Eventing includes three disciplines: a show ring competition, endurance test, cross-country. The height is limited, but the difficulty of an endurance test and obstacles are difficult. The horse must have high endurance for this. Cross-country involves an obstacle course and pure high jumping. Horses have to jump more than 160 centimeters in Olympic Games. Dressage is horse dancing. When the horse jumps high, it is very impressive. The racing courses are always different and their level of difficulty varies. But in this sport is always some new experience, and the adrenaline surge you get from horse riding is absolutely incredible. At first I started doing show jumping because I thought it was an exciting form of extreme sport full of adrenaline, and the first jump is very impressive. I didn't give it a second thought. I got a horse who could jump and do dressage, all the elements I need. I tried and got better at this, and then was sent to competitions where I had good performances, and now I continue doing show jumping and dressage.
Я попала в учебную группу, занималась буквально год, нарабатывала азы какие-то, вот основы. Затем тренера поставили передо мной вопрос, куда я хочу в конкурсе выйти.
I got into a training group, which was literally for a year involved in training the basics. Then the coaches put me into a dilemma: what do I want to do, show jumping or dressage? I didn't even know what dressage is. Like what? Dressage? A parallel world for me. I knew that I wanted jumping, and I said so. My parents warned me that it was dangerous, and I'm their only daughter. So they advised me to take up dressage. I was upset at first and even cried. But in half a year, I got into it, liked it very much. I watched videos of experienced riders and just lit up. I can't say exactly how many horses I have had since I frequently changed them. But this is considered a good thing for a young rider who must go through a lot of horses. The more the better, because the rider will learn many patterns of a horse's behavior. Then you can mount a horse, and in a minute you will be able to understand how to effectively control it. The first meeting with a horse is very important. The first thing to do is, of course, give it sugar, greet it, and whisper in its ear, "Let's be friends." Then I get to know the horse better when I'm on her back. When I am given a new horse, at first we get used to each other, our behavior, our temper. But so far I don't have the same deep connection I have with Avalon. This is an inner connection. We understand each other without words. We just see one another and understand.
Характер, но это еще не такая глубокая привязанность. У нас с Авалоном уже сложилась такая внутренняя привязанность. Мы понимаем друг друга без слов, мы практически не общаемся. Просто видим друг друга и понимаем.
I've been doing equestrian sports for 6 years, show jumping to be exact. Why show jumping? Because I feel myself free when I jump with the horse. It's adrenaline, I like it. To achieve any result, you must find a common language with the horse. This isn't easy, but it's possible. You can just go for a walk with a horse once in a while and talk to it. I have three of them, and each needs special attention and tender loving care. There are a lot of equestrian clubs right nowadays. Many of them are quite advanced and have a sound infrastructure. They are mostly in the rural areas in the Kyiv and Chernihiv oblast. A new one has recently appeared in the Kharkiv oblast. It is a very good club.
Начала я занятия буквально с 2 дней в неделю. Занималась так буквально 2 года или 3 даже. Понятно, что прогресса было мало, так как для профессионала.
At first I trained for 2 days a week. This continued for 2 or 3 years. I didn't make such progress because this is not enough time for professional sportsmanship. Then I started training every day. I progressed quickly and the results came fast. I think the relationship with the coach must be warm, close and family-like, because every day during the training we encounter problems, the coach supports me, offers advice, sometimes scolds me, of course, only to make me perform better. Since the first training, the most difficult for me was mounting the horse. For a long time I couldn't do it. I didn't have the strength in my arms to pull myself up onto the saddle. Back then, nobody allowed us to use a stool to climb onto a horse, because it was through that only accomplished athletes can allow themselves such a luxury, while the young must learn to do it on their own. Then came the common instruction, heels down and toes to the horse. This was my number one problem. I was totally uncoordinated, my right toe stood out more than the left one, so it was difficult for me to keep them parallel to the horse. After that, the number of training sessions increased and I overcame the problem. Now I don't even have to try. I do it right the first time and it's almost automatic.
Эта проблема стала уходить даже просто незаметно. Сейчас я об этом не задумываюсь, оно все на автомате.
I started falling when I started jumping, after around 3-4 months of training. I fell often because I couldn't hold myself in the saddle. During the first year, I wanted to quit because it was hard to get up at 6 a.m. to train and my muscles ached for about 6 months. But I understood that if I quit, I would never be as happy as I was. Moreover, communicating with horses helps me both with my inner and outer strength, so it's a physical synergy between me and the horse.
Ну, мне как-то помогает.
Ты всю жизнь, пока ты в седле, пока ты рядом с лошадью, ты все время чему-то.
For your entire life, when you are in the saddle, when you are near a horse, you learn something. You talk to the other people, everyone can change your perspective on your relationship with your horse and in your work with the horse. So we, horse riders, learn our whole life in this process. At first, I trained in a group of dummies, as we call it, that meant a beginner's group. Then our coach took me to a show jumping group. I made some jumps, debuts and done children show jumping. I've had a very good horse, she wasn't deemed the best in our stable. She was ill-tempered, but tender loving care made her better. I started giving her treats, walking her, grooming her, and while she was very unsociable at first, she started to acknowledge me, help me, and then we started winning competitions. Our kids did well, even got some top places in Europe. They were up to 14 years old. We took 7th place at the Olympics, which is very good for our level. I'm very pleased with this achievement. Naturally, there is always room for improvement, and I think that we will get even better in the future. Our sport is very particular. It would seem that men are stronger and it must be easier for them, but strength alone cannot guarantee victory. And of course, it is always pleasant to defeat a male rider, especially if he is older and stronger. It is very satisfying, but victory doesn't always depend on whether you are male or female. It depends to a great degree on experience, skill and perseverance. I often get upset during the training sessions, but I never quit, never stop doing what I'm doing, and I never think that I wasn't made for this form of sport. Horses, mainly their energy, have great influence on their rider, and many problems lose their significance when you have such a close friend always by your side.